Sunfall. The Mad King Duran Summer Palace. A bulwark of Tarkin life against the howling Forbidden West.
Thanks for the history lesson.
But they have no idea what lies beneath. We will learn much from this, Aloy.
That's what I'm hoping.
I think these disappearances are a blessing. It's the sun drawing the faithful out of misery.
Ugh. The whole world feels like a...
The Sun Ring. Proud tradition of Tarkin.
Stay off my focus.
If the eclipse catches you here, you'll be lucky if you survive long enough to wind up in that ring. Now we get to see if your attack on their focus network was entirely successful. Success. Welcome to the Citadel, Aloy. I'll check back with you in a moment. In the meantime, circulate.
Outlanders, if you want to hear about today's bounties, head for the throne room. You're not going to make any shards by standing out here.
Filthy mercenary bottom feeders.
I'll take the shards, even if it means having to listen to Bahavas.
I hear the Shadow Conjure are looking for one of their own. Should pay well.
Have you noticed all the empty tents lately? It's like people are just vanishing.
By the glory of the sun revealed. Behold, radiant Edoman, the one true Sun King, the light in shadow, whose will is light and whose light is law.
I command Lucian Bahavas to speak in my behalf.
By the will of Radiant Edoman does the sun glare down mercilessly upon the traitor Uthid. To the hunter who brings his head to us shall go a bounty of 500 shards.
More prisoners than royalty, don't you think? Love your hair. You and I need to chat, little huntress. The green tent down in Shadowside? I'll be waiting.
Kind of busy.
We both know you're no killer for hire. Uthid is innocent. So come see me while there's still time to save him.
So, the way in I spoke of is right behind you.
You've got to be kidding.
Not at all. And you needn't worry about the Kestrels. They'll be too busy acting important to pay attention to you.
First time in the Citadel. Gotta see the Sun Ring from on high.
But the Kestrels.
Ah! They want us to see this, boy!
This is insane.
It makes quite an impression.
They're going to see me.
You underestimate the balustrade. It's a short drop from there.
More food on ice.
First time in the Citadel, gotta see the Sun Ring from
the balustrade. It's a short drop from there.
Ah, they want us to see this, boy. It makes quite an impression.
The other side of the tower. Look for a vent.
I see you've been here before.
Obviously. Now, it's very important that you hear what I'm about to say. I've shown you the way in, but this humble vent marks a point of no return. Before you descend to the depths here, you should be fully committed, equipped, and focused. No distractions. If you have errands to run, do them first or hold your peace. I won't tolerate whining. Is that clear?
You'll tolerate what I give you, Silence. I didn't ask you along for the ride. I'm heading down.
I've spent a lifetime trying to uncover the secrets of this world. Where the machines came from. How the old ones achieved such marvels only to fall into silence and death. A lifetime of failure, as year by year, decade after decade, I hit walls I could not break, doors I could never breach.
Hello.
Until Honora Huntress marched out of the savage east. And, voila, for her, all the deepest secrets of the earth were laid bare. I suspect you will have an easier time with this door than I did years ago.
Hold for identiscan. Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Malfunction. 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 Malfunction.
Are you kidding me?
You don't hear me laughing.
Shut up. There's gotta be another way. Hey! Elizabeth Sobeck here! Requesting access!
Access request acknowledged. Root command functions available. Do you wish to proceed?
I do! Get me through this door!
Analyzing. Primary access inoperable due to mechanical failure. Emergency venting procedure likely to circumvent blockage. Do you wish to proceed?
Yes.
Emergency venting authorized.
I underestimated. Took my power.
Have everything.
That will draw attention. We won't have this place to ourselves for long now.
We? Last I checked, I was the one risking my life down here.
Yes, fine. Now will you please get moving? There's so much to learn in less time than I'd hoped.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn.
Zero Dawn. We found it.
Are you really so surprised?
Facility diagnostics detect multiple failures. Attempting repair.
So, what was this room?
An entrance hall, perhaps. Have a look around.
Please take a seat and wait for your name to be called. A selection of beverages and snacks are available. Please proceed into viewing room one for an important message regarding the purpose of your visit.
Holographic theater.
ZD-01 data intact. Initiating playback.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn. I am General Harris, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff of the United States of America. I'm sure you've heard the rumors that Zero Dawn is a top secret super weapons program, the technological miracle that will save us from the Pharaoh Plague. If Operation Enduring Victory can hold off the robots long enough. The reason I'm sure you've heard the rumors is that I'm the one who spread them, and they are all lies. Zero Dawn is not a super weapons program, and it will not save us. Nothing will save us. Here's why. By the time the glitch was noticed, it was already too late. Nothing could stop the Pharaoh Plague. Nothing can. Its robots will continue to replicate and devour the biosphere. life on Earth will be destroyed. Our planet reduced to a barren sphere. Global extinction is inevitable. No matter how many we kill, the robots just keep exponentially making more. If we had their deactivation codes, we could shut them all down. The entire swarm. But since their cryptographic protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, cracking a code set would take half a century. At best, we've got 16 months. Not exactly what you'd call a survival option. The destruction of a biosphere is not the sort of apocalypse you can wait out in a fallout shelter or a space station. There will be no Earth left to reclaim. Just a lifeless, toxic rock with several million pharaoh robots on it, hibernating, waiting for something to eat. This is the horrible truth behind the lies of Operation Enduring Victory. My lies. Lies designed to inspire millions of innocents to sacrifice themselves in battle. Why? One reason. To buy time for you and the work you will do here. Zero Day. The day that life on Earth ceases to exist is coming fast. It cannot be stopped. The hope of Zero Dawn is that something new might come after. But I will leave it to Elizabeth Sobeck to shine that thin ray of light into the darkness. Harris, out.
That doesn't make sense. Life on Earth didn't cease to exist.
He said it could not be stopped.
But it was. Somehow Elizabeth saved us. I've got to keep looking. Find out how she did it. Kestrels. They got in. Through the vents.
Let nothing stop you from learning the truth.
Spread out! If it moves, kill it!
What is this place? Tomb?
Mystery. You're building a colony ship. It's obvious. and it's not gonna fly. I mean, literally. Remember the Odyssey? That multinational heap of space junk that's been in graveyard orbit since 57? That went nowhere real slow, and you have to get somewhere real fast. Do you have any idea the immensity of the challenge to prep a new colony ship in time?
To be clear, I'm not a worker on the project.
Do you even understand how few people it could save? The whole generation...
Elizabeth Sobeck. You've heard the bad news, and it's all true. The Pharaoh Plague is devouring the biosphere. Life itself will cease to exist. But does that have to be the end? What if we could give life a future? What if we could build a kind of seed from which, on a dead planet, life could blossom anew? This is the aim, the hope, of Project Zero Dawn. To create a super-intelligent, fully automated terraforming system and bring life back from lifelessness. What would such a system require? At its core, it would need a true AI, fully capable of making the trillions of decisions necessary to reconstitute the biosphere. An immortal guardian, devoted to the re-flourishing of life. We call it Gaia. Mother Nature as an AI. But that's just the core of the system. She will need to be surrounded and empowered by a comprehensive suite of subordinate functions. Think of them as extensions of Gaia's mind, each dedicated to a specific purpose. Now, these aren't AIs, but make no mistake, each presents an engineering challenge more profound than anything the human species has ever before attempted. Hardware that preserves and then gestates the billions of seeds and embryos from which life will be reborn. The construction of underground facilities to hold it all. And that's just the start. We don't have to build the entire system. The beauty of a fully automated terraforming system is that it can build itself. Now, over the days to come, you'll learn how all these functions, all these pieces that you'll be working on, fit together. How we'll race the clock to execute our harvest initiatives, write the software, build the tech and the facilities. How we'll lock it down and seal it up before the inevitable occurs. But even more important, you'll know how it doesn't end here. How Gaia will generate those deactivation codes General Harris talked about, and build the transmission arrays to broadcast them, shutting down the Pharaoh robots for good. How Gaia will not just build, but imagine any conceivable robot it needs to do its work across centuries. From detoxifying the Earth's ravaged atmosphere and poisoned seas, to the regreening of the Earth from cryopreserved seed stocks, to rewilding the Earth with animal life. And then, when all that is done, how a new generation of human beings, spawned at cradle facilities around the globe, will partake of Apollo. The vast archive of human knowledge and cultural achievement from which they will learn of us, our world. And most important, how not to repeat our mistakes. It's not an impossible dream. It is within our grasp if we work tirelessly and stop at nothing to achieve it. We can't stop life from ending. But if you will help me, help Gaia, we can give it a future. Join me and help make that future real.
The whole Earth destroyed, but then remade?
Yes, by a machine. A machine of creation.
Elizabeth. Did this for life, for us. Why Hades then? If it was part of Gaia, how did it end up in the wreckage of a Pharaoh robot? Why does it want to kill me? And Apollo, the archive of knowledge, what happened to that?
I'm as confused as you are. Maybe the answers lie ahead.
Intruder! Get her!
Who? Me?
Whatever you do, don't die now.
Family will be saved because I happen to graduate in art history? Is this right?
Dr. Souvet? Christina Souvet?
Yes. I met a man, another historian. His fields are Bauhaus and the New Materialists. But he once attended one of my talks. Another unfair chance. Of all the many people in that auditorium, that we should both be here now. And yet, I feel more accepting of my fate. No, it is not fair, not at all. But for the sake of my family, for the sake of art. Art is alive. It must be able to speak from beyond history and echo in the future, not perish into oblivion. This opportunity, I must do this.
Incompetence, okay? Somehow, he managed to...
I should check the door nearby. found one. Looks intact. That should do the trick. Now let's get that door open. That did it. Door should have power.
Now to see what lies beyond it.
They're here.
Avoid contact.
Lines look good.
Gaia, it's up there. Second floor.
Can you reach it?
So much for avoiding contact.
Down.
Shadow commands it!
I'm Margot Shen, and this is Hephaestus. As the name might tip you off, this is going to be the subordinate function that Gaia will use to make lots and lots of robots. Her personal forge. Except, it's not that simple. You probably noticed that only about a third of you are robotics engineers. The rest, experts in machine cognition, virtual heuristics, that stuff. Well, that's because we aren't going to be the ones designing and building robots. The last thing we want is to burden Gaia with a bunch of outmoded 21st century designs. Waste of time. Our purpose is to empower Gaia to build the robots. And not just build, imagine, from scratch. Any robot she needs for any conceivable purpose, designed and fabricated at a snap of a finger. Hers. Her finger. So, Hephaestus isn't really the forge. It's more like the knowledge of craft and ingenuity of a mastersmith to wield the hammer. Encoded as software. Virtual creativity made real. Gaia's already learning. In simulation, she's doing some very creative things with fractal assembly and animal morphologies. Her designs aren't about to win the Liam Prize anytime soon. But hey, everyone has to start somewhere. So, yes, time to get started. Let's do this.
I don't get it.
Which part? It's a little technical in places.
If Gaia was designed, I've seen these shapes before. In cauldrons.
But of course. The birthing places of Gaia's machines.
I think this is it. Elizabeth Sobeck's office. But it's sealed off. There's got to be a way inside.
Keep looking.
More Eclipse.
Careful now.
do what I must for the Shadow, but I don't like it.
Welcome to Apollo, the collective memory of the human species and the wellspring of knowledge for future generations. I am Samina Ebaji. Until recently, I was director of the International Collective Memory Institute in New Tehran. As a heritage professional, I devoted my career to the preservation of human knowledge, creative endeavor, and cultural achievement. Apollo is, therefore, the ultimate embodiment of a lifelong passion, albeit under the very worst circumstances imaginable. The challenges before us are immense. Specifically, we will have to design and implement 4 major initiatives simultaneously. First, the construction of data repositories in cradle facilities around the world, ensuring redundancy. Second, the collection and processing of a projected 180 million discrete data.
All of this lost. The ancients' greatest gift to us.
Greatest? How about the fact we exist at all?
To abide in ignorance is a curse, Aloy. You of all people should know that.
She's just one savage. How much of a threat can she be?
Of them. Alone once more.
In what should have been a cave of wonders.
Welcome to Hades, Zero Dawn's extinction failsafe protocol. the ultimate killer app. Now, I know what you're thinking. The purpose of Gaia is to resurrect life.
So why give her a subordinate function, only purpose of which is to wipe out life all over again?
What's that?
What? Just plumb crazy, ain't it?
Well, no, it isn't. Reconstituting a biosphere? That's a tall order. Tech smart as Gaia may be, odds are she won't get it right the first time. I mean, imagine you're Gaia, 200 years from now, and this new biosphere growing, it's all gone wrong. Alkalines are skyrocketing, coniferous forests eroding under the lash of superstorms that would have drowned Noah.
It's chaos. Even in time, they won't stop wobbling. What are you gonna do?
Release phase one organisms into that hot mess? Hope their CO2 and methane can balance out what you got started?
Looks like the only way onwards.
Welcome to Eleuthia, the crown and king of Gaia's subordinate functions. For it is by Eleuthia that the human race will continue to exist. I am Patrick Brochard-Klein, the Alpha in charge of this program. Now let one thing be perfectly clear from the outset. Eleuthia is not a genetic engineering project. Our goal is to preserve the human genome, not alter it. A snapshot of human genetic diversity, literally frozen in time. The genetic quintessence of our species, unmodified. Under my watch, our activities and initiatives will comply with the 2034 cloning regulations and the 2048 rally accords. Now that may seem quaint, is a trivial concern to you in light of present circumstances, but...
Cradle facilities. Elizabeth said a new generation of humans would be spawned inside such places.
She did.
All Mother Mountain. It was one of them?
There's only one way to be sure.
The hatch wouldn't open. Something about a corrupted Alpha registry. I need to search Elizabeth's office. Something.
That's what benefit from antilopony morphologies. Though caprid forms show superior load bearing.
You will undergo a brief period of unconsciousness during relocation to Prime and final instatement.
Elizabeth, may I speak outside protocol?
When you're back up and running at the new site, we'll bring the subordinate functions online and see where we stand.
Elizabeth.
Pure logic won't cut it, Ted. To pull this off, Gaia's going to need to have some skin in the game. It has to care.
What if it runs amok? Have we learned nothing from our mistakes?
Your mistakes, I think you mean?
All I'm saying is give it a kill switch.
She was just born, Ted. I'm not gonna put a gun to her head while she's still in the cradle.
You talk like it's a child. What if it becomes a monster?
Elizabeth, may I speak outside protocol?
Of course, Gaia, go on.
I'm sorry to contradict you, but Mr. Pharaoh's argument is sound. At this point, the development of my psyche is not entirely predictable. To ensure preservation of life, a hardwired override is, I believe, a necessary safeguard.
There. Satisfied, Ted?
Jeez, Liz, just do what it says.
the Alpha Registry master file.
Intact?
Yeah. No signs of corruption.
Then what are you waiting for? Copy the file.
With this, I can restore the registry at the hatch inside Allmother. Open it. Go inside.
And grasp the secrets within.
Where I was born. Maybe. Maybe who gave birth to me.
Who? Are you really so naive? There'll be no who waiting for you there, Aloy. Whatever birthed you into the world was a what, not a who.
You bastard.
Oh no, I had a legitimate birth. It's you, Aloy, who are the creation of a machine. But what kind of machine and why? Why were you created?
Eclipse.
You need to get out of there. What you found is too valuable. You're too valuable.
Suitable death in mind for you, child.